Hi guys, Ernest. In this video, I'm gonna show you my latest modification on FX Impact. It's the titanium short throw cocking lever. This piece and the linkage is made out of titanium. It makes the turning radius quicker because it's shorter, right? And it's a night and day when you're actually using it. All right, it helps out a lot with guys like me with short hands. All right, I had guys with big hands shooting it, and they feel comfortable with it also. And they said, it's like the lock time is quicker in cocking it. Right, is this going to be available as a complete unit like this one? Is a as a normal cocking handle inside with a 2 mil thick carbon fiber sleeve over it. All right, and it'll be available also with just plain, you know, plain and use your own handle, whatever you have in there. Even you have my custom handles in there, you screw it in there. All right, and yeah, and I'm gonna show you how to install it. All right, let's do it. All right, first thing is remove the barrel. It doesn't have to be degassed because we're not breaking the pressure boundary. So we're gonna loosen all the screws in the top rail. Let me zoom out more. Right there. All right, remove it. It's a simple drop-in accessory. Mind you, this is only for a 2.5 mil cocking pin on the MK2 reloading block. And if you do have the older one, you can request to have a 2 mil hole, I mean a 2 mil instead of 2.5. All right, raise up. Yep. Then you remove this piece, this screw, lift up the rear barrel mount and lift the handle up. It's really tight tolerance, so there's a whole kit. All right, and mind you, I have a little safety device, what I call it. It's to prevent breaking your cocking pin. Cocking pin is this piece here. It used to be, you know, it's common if you leave your cocking handle partially open or not fully closed. If this is in a way, right, if it's partially open, the hammer is going to hit the cocking pin right here. Well, it's going to hit this cocking pin, not the linkage pin, but it's going to absorb the blow and snap this cocking pin. To minimize that, I made this hole elongated, so it loses some kind of, it loses its force before it breaks this piece. It goes forward and back just a little bit, like 0.35 mil, but it's a tighter tolerance, it doesn't move side to side. All right, if you notice that, it's common, it was designed that way. All right, let's say you have this piece, you use your own handle, we'll install that just like that, then put on your block. So it goes flush, let me tighten it down. All right, then your cocking assembly. When you put it down, align your cocking pin down. And when it's flush, And it's even gap here and in the back. That means you got your hockey puck installed. Nothing is loose, preventing it from closing. Put on your forward barrel mount. All right, put top plate on. All right, we'll thread about 1 or 2 threads and all of these screws. All right, we'll put the barrel back on to make sure this action and the rear block is aligned properly. You have to tighten it down, just make sure the brass goes inside to the block. All right, then we tighten it down. Usually I start from forward to back. Well, let me show you another way instead of just tightening it down. You know, I usually cycle this and tighten it. When you close it, it gives pressure to this barrel mount, make sure it's square with the barrel. Then you tighten it down. Go from back, then middle. Alright, then we tighten down your barrel. Well, in case you tighten it down right now, you got it installed. Yeah, works really good. And it's look like aluminum, as raw material, right? Titanium. So you see the milling tools, you can see it, but it's smooth and flush all the way around. There's no really sharp object. It's nicely milled but non-anodized. So I prefer it this way. You could paint it if you want, but I like the raw titanium. All right, we'll see you soon, next video.